quit doing this to your hairline. Golly.
Oh!
Somebody! Oh!
He needs some milk!
Today! Oh my god, what is that? Oh my god! What is that?
Welcome back to another video of Activerse Universe. Today is a new day! Yeah, we got a what? We got a biker! We got a banger! We got a banger! Banger! Let's go! Let's go! Hype it up! Hype it up! Hey! Hype it up!
Let's go!
Hype it up! Ooh! Hype it up! Ooh! Alright, done with the hype part, man. We're gonna keep the energy still high because I'm gonna be telling you guys what not to do today, man. Quit doing this to your hairline. Golly. You know, I'm one of the top leaders in the big forehead gang on the dreadlock community. Actually, I'm probably not. I probably have the average forehead. What do y'all think? Let's see. Forehead?
Cap.
Yeah. My. I guess five head. Okay, so I got five head. What do you have? Comment down below. This is things you should not be doing if you have a dreadlocks or even have regular hair. You shouldn't be doing this to your hairline, man. Number one, quit having them comb down your hair at the barbershop and lining your hair up. That is really bad for your hair for one main reason. And it's because every time they're trying to comb it down, and I used to be a barber actually. So when I did it, I remember just combing down different people's hair or even mine. And what happens is every time you comb your hair down, more starts to come out of from your actual locks. So now your locks end up basically getting all the way down here. And you know, it gives you a crispy line up. I ain't gonna lie. That's the best way to get a crispy line up. That's not the way to have your dreadlocks for the future. So I've met a lot of people, including my brother Dune, that actually used to cut their hair like that to where it climbed up, and then literally was back here, like literally back here. Mine was not too terrible, but it was like half an inch. A lot of people have actually an inch in the front, and they you know, combed it down, got it there in the beginning, or through the process of time, I got it. The problem with the process of time is as they start lining your hairline up, to get it crispy, they have to keep combing down more hair, taking away from the dreads and of your front hair, which will end up, you know, giving you skinny locks in the front. And if you already have skinny locks, it's even going to get thinner. And now they're lining it up, and the result in it, and it's being a really crispy lineup, but at the same time you actually pushing your hairline back slight. I know some people that have already cut like an inch down, so they don't have to worry about screwing their hairline back or anything like that, and I can understand that. But if you started your dreadlocks with fully locking it up in the front, like using all the maximum hair, and you start combing it down, what you're start doing is actually start thinning out the hairs on your side and in the front. So if you already haven't done it from the beginning, quit doing that in the process of your dreadlocks. If you have done it in the beginning, like I said, different, because you already escaped the part that they're gonna brush down and keep lining up. You already got it down to like up to here. Now there is no way they need to go all the way back here to comb more hair down. Of course they'll end up getting some hair down, but it wouldn't be as bad result as if you already started early growing this hair out for your dreadlocks, and not cutting it or combing it down will actually have a greater effect. So like I said, there's two parts to it. If you haven't started, don't do it. If you already started an inch or an inch and a half or something like that, and continue to do it, unless you want to grow it out and connect them to your dreadlocks, which is not a bad idea, but at the same time the growth process is going to get ugly, so don't do that. This is how to protect your hairline, man. The hairline is your main part of your hair. That is what everybody, even with females, your edges is your main part. And number two tip will actually go also for females, because y'all need to keep your edges. So whatever product that you're going to use for your hair, females and men, don't do over excessive amount of products that can actually hurt your hair, and mainly being bleach. So there are some females that I see that really dye your whole entire hair and the bottom, like your roots of your hair. So what end up happening is your baby hair, one of the thinnest part of your hair entirely. Out of your whole entire hair, your baby hair is the thinnest hair. And you bleaching it will get even more thinner, because you're taking away from the melanin and you're taking away from the strength of the dreadlocks. Bleaching your hair, I've talked about it in the last previous video, I think it's two videos before, you can click right here. But bleaching your hair has an effect for your dreadlocks. There is a good way method of doing bleacher, just like there is a healthy amount of washing your hair, because you can't overwash your hair too. Same way with bleach, you can't over bleach your hair, because it end up eating your hair. And the problem that I've seen with a lot of people people that do bleaches to their hair is that they actually apply it to their roots, to their front hairline and different things like that, resulting it in thinning out. I've known some people that actually bleach their hair, and basically what happened is they wanted like a haircut that went like this, like you know, the line that goes right there, and I lined it up. I bleached the hair first and I lined it up later, and I hit it with the razor, and literally the parts that I hit with the razor after bleaching it was like done, like it was just literally like gone. But of course some hair came back out, some of them covered, but the hairline was really hard to get back because getting hit with a razor on top of a bleach, that's tough for your baby hair, y'all. And so be careful not to do that, and that goes for both men and women. So be careful to protect your hairline, because man, this is the best part of your hair. Going to the number three that I want you guys to be mindful of is when you guys go to a barber shop, watch out for the enhancements. I know you're trying to get really crispy with your dreadlocks, you're trying to get, you know, even regular hair, trying to get crispy with your lineups and different things, you end up having an excessive amount of product, sprayers, razors, alcohol, different things being added to your hairline, man. You gotta be careful. If you go to your barber, just tell them to line you up natural lineup. Why don't you just do that? Start liking yourself, start loving yourself that way. I know going to a barbershop, one of the biggest thing that I noticed is that they do give you a crispy lineup with enhancements and different things like that, but what later on it does, you don't know. The side effects that it has, the amount of stuff that it may be doing curling to your hair, you don't know. You don't know what is inside that coloring or that enhancement they spray on your head. You don't know how much of your baby hairs are being getting pushed back. Every time you're trying to get a quote unquote crispy lineup and they're using razors. And razors basically gets you a really crispy look. I'm not saying it takes away your whole entire hair, but at the same time, why keep shaving your baby hair? Those are the things that won't grow back in the future. As for me, what I did was I stopped touching my baby hairs. Every time I line it up, when I see like a, you know, a hair sticking out, that's when I hit it. And that's why you see me with a natural hairline all the time. And you see it a little bit slanted because it's naturally that way. I don't think there's nobody in this world, anybody in this world that has a really crispy perfect parallel that matches both of their head, and like this side being perfect with this side even being perfect with this side. I don't think anybody does. So why do you just feel like that you need to cover that up with it with products? You know, even for a woman, be careful that gels and stuff like that that you guys apply to your baby hair. I noticed that gel, what it does is dries your hair out, and when it dries your hair out, your baby hair out, it's easy for it to snap, it's easy for it to break, things to happen to it. So why are you guys risking a lot of things? Be careful of the excessive amount. Like I'm saying, I'm not saying don't do it, I'm saying excessive amount of your hair, because it can end up damaging your hair. This is all I have for you guys today. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and learned a lot from it. This is my hair currently right now. This is what it's looking like with the two strand twist I recently did, and also a retwist on my head. This is one of my favorite looks and I love it because it's easy to do, and with the thickness of my hair, what it does is that it bulks out, or it just pops out in your eye how curvy it is, how thick it is, and different things like that. For a lot of people that have skinny dreadlocks, for them to do this, it's kind of like impossible almost, because they have to do maybe three strand twist or two strand twist and double it up with another twist to get the look, the thickness of this. So mine originally started thick, so it looks really good when it comes to this. On the next week video, I'm actually going to be showing you guys how to style your hair, two strand twist, or what I used to call them, two gun twist, because Gunther the Great used to have a channel called Guns Locked. I think it's called Guns Locked. Yeah, now it changed to Great Locks. So I used to call them that, and I did two strand twist. Even before having dreadlocks, I did two strand twist. So if you guys have not done any two strand twist on a regular hair, you don't have to have dreadlocks, you guys can go check out that video that's gonna be dropping next week. Thank you guys for watching this video, but till next time, keep acting diverse and creating your universe. I'm out. Love y'all.
Yes, sir, ski.